is a late Lupercalia / Valentine's Day massacre gift, the Hermetic Brotherhood presents more theater and yet another so-called mass shooting. And in honor of so-called Black History Month, formerly Black History Week, thank you. The shooting suspect this time was a Black man, age 45. 4 + 5 = 9, an inversion of 6, which when put together give us 69, which just happens to symbolize hermeticism and duality. 6 and 9, when added together numerologically, still equals 6. Gary Martin was the alleged shooter's name, and it took place, supposedly, in Aurora, Illinois. So now we have an Aurora shooting in Illinois, South Highland Street, and the Aurora Dark Knight shooting. Interesting. Aurora relates to the dawn. The Brotherhood always speaks about the new dawn. The gunman supposedly was taken into custody, according to first reports, which I was listening to, at 3:03. There we have duality. 3:22 was also a significant timestamp in the initial breaking news announcement. Genesis 3:22 in Skull and Bones, yes, but of more contemporary importance is the beginning of Aries, which means war. 4 officers were shot. Supposedly, the man was an employee of FedEx, which I gathered was located inside of the Henry Pratt building, a factory facility. We first heard from John Probst, his co-worker, for the initial interview. He was an older man. He said that Martin went into work, he did his time, and he didn't see any indication that he was about to go quote-unquote postal. However, a nearby neighbor, a younger man, at least by how he sounded, named Gabriel, which happens to be the messenger angel, and who the Greeks confused as Hermes, or Mercury of the Romans, was interviewed after the co-worker and this neighbor gave the message most clearly, using upspeak, of course. First, the report said that the victims were stabilized, and as the Ouroboros continued to swallow its tail, they played a 9/11 dispatch recording that clearly said there were multiple fatalities. Clayton Muhammad, city spokesperson, was vague in telling what neutralized meant after reports came out that the suspect, Gary Martin, had been neutralized. According to military speak, that usually means terminated. Old Kells was probably glad something was taking the heat off of him. And notice how we're focusing on Chicago at this time. It happened in Kane County, and no matter how you spell it, it always relates back to the original tonology, which would be Kane, or the sons of Kane, the first murderer. My age and the nagging spirit of nostalgia sometimes makes me think about the smooth operator, but usually if I see Kane, symbolism for the first killer or murder come to mind. Now, we've been here before, and experience tells us that they wait until they get their story straight, and then they tell a lie laced with symbolism at the first press conference, which came at 5:00 Chicago time. First, they said they apprehended the suspect, which is very different from neutralizing, aka killing them. At about 3:45 p.m., Muhammad speaks, the city spokesperson, pun intended, another Chicago reference, and says neutralized, a vague and ambiguous term that does not have to mean, but usually does mean, shot. When things like this are organic, a shooter who wounds multiple officers will be dealt with using deadly force. In past examples, what we've seen is that the language used in telling the initial story differs greatly from the controlled information that gets dished out later, and as the situation gets turned into yet another false flag or hoax ritual. It is likely that they present a man as the shooter, who is an actor playing the role of the villain. This suspense and drama also had its share of mystery, as it was full of Illuminati symbolism, quote unquote. 401 Marshall is the main office of the Henry Pratt Building. Mass shootings always raise truthers' suspicions about gun control and its most extreme form, martial law. True to the nature of the Hermetic Theater and the Theater of War, they kept folks guessing, but they also distracted a lot of people from issues that would definitely be more pertinent to the average American and to anyone who was concerned about their freedom, the Second Amendment, or their civil rights. Yet another shutdown was avoided, laugh now, and a national emergency was declared, cry later. Sure, we need a wall to keep out the dope that the U.S. and its operatives fly over and bring back to the inner cities. I've never seen a Mexican dope man in Detroit with a plane. Saudis, that's something different. But those are his pals. They're good people.
So I'm going to be signing a national emergency. And it's been signed many times before. It's been signed by other presidents. From 1977 or so, it gave the presidents the power. There's rarely been a problem. They sign it. Nobody cares. I guess they weren't very exciting. But nobody cares. They sign it for far less important things.
A national emergency may precede martial law. The president has powers that go beyond normal checks and balances during these emergencies, we are told. But these inaugurated augurs do not pull the strings nor call the shots. They are all selected, not elected. A religious brotherhood really runs things around here, and they are not followers of the Messiah, Christ-like or Christian. This act by the POTUS would have and should have been big news. Yet what dominated the news cycle was more sensational and a lot more symbolic. Coincidentally, 322 weeks ago was Friday, December 14th, 2012. 2012 was also the year of the Aurora, Colorado shooting, but there's more. The Sandy Crook Elementary School shooting occurred on December 14th, 2012, in Newtown, United States, when 20-year-old Adam Lanza fatally shot 20 children, we are told, between 6 and 7, equaling 13. Between 6 and 7 years old, as well as 6, they love the number 6, adult staff members. The irony of it, 322 weeks ago. So 322 weeks ago, we were focused on Connect I Cut, called Connecticut. And Skull and Bones is an undergraduate senior secret society at Yale University in New Haven, Connecticut. You have Newtown and New Haven. The number 322 appears in Skull and Bones insignia and is widely reported to be significant as the year of Greek orator Demosthenes' death. Many truthers have conveniently and suspiciously forgotten about the true selectors of modern presidents. Brotherhood groups like the Freemasons, Jesuits, Zionists, Bohemian Grove members, the Trilateral Commission, the Bilderbergers, and the Bonesmen really call the shots. Completion to the true and living God is death to the Bonesmen, hence the seven. So the 322 refers to seven, as in the end, their version of completion, and also Genesis 3:22. And the Lord God said, "Behold, the man is become as one of us to know good and evil. And now lest he put forth his hand and take also the tree of life and eat and live forever." Look up the date of the start of W's war on Iraq, and then you'll see another connection to that 322. Aries is the first astrological sign in the zodiac, the male of the first three signs representing a false trinity of the male god or sun god, Aries, god of war or fire. Then you have the moon god or moon goddess, Taurus, earth, and then you have Gemini, air. the two children, or the double-minded single child. Those that study astrology would say that March 21st or 321, the official beginning of Aries, is still heavily influenced by Pisces. And the next day, according to these astrotheists, 322 would be the official start of total Aries energy, the spirit of murder, killing, death. The 322 again of the skull and bones. And Aries was called the god of war by ancient Romans, who knew him as Mars. Investigative truthers have discovered more instances than mere so-called coincidences could explain. It is mathematically impossible that these same numbers would randomly pop up in hundreds of controlled camera shots for no reason at all in movie after movie and television program after program. Those familiar with the Purge franchise are also aware of the 322's relationship to murder, death, killing, and bloodshed. Famous Luciferian, Masonic philosopher, and Confederate General Albert Pike said that both the 32 and 33rd, or honorary degrees, could be told the secret that Lucifer is their god. Whether 32nd or 33rd, we're talking about James 1 and 8 double-minded men. The 32nd degree has Latin up under its double-headed eagle that says, "My hope is in God." Men cannot merely choose to be a 33rd degree. You must be, quote-unquote, tapped in order to receive initiation into this, the honorary degree. Mostly, it is the stars of any given field that are selected to receive this degree. The Latin slogan below the double-headed demonic 33rd degree bird says, "God and my moral rightness," which is a direct relation to their double-mindedness, where they believe themselves to be right or wise in their own eyes, and they lean to their own understanding, oftentimes having to double cross each other. So you see the importance, symbolism of the doubles. And 33 also, once again, adds up to 6. Multiplied is 9. Duality, once again. Per the usual Brotherhood way, interesting words, names, and numbers are associated all throughout the story today. 401 South Highland Avenue is where the Henry Pratt building was located, which was the site of the so-called mass shooting. Highland is the mountainous part of Scotland. Think Highlander. North of Glasgow, often associated with Gaelic culture. Gaelic culture means clans and kilts. Could it also refer to the House of the 33rd or Scottish Rite double cross action? The Aurora, Illinois shooting story also brings to mind the St. Valentine's Day massacre, where 7 members and associates of Chicago's Northside Gang were murdered. Many more connections tie this post-millennium shooting esoterically to the one in Aurora, Colorado in 2012, again with the 2012. Are these the new 9/11s, psyops for gun control, and racial tension? Then there's the obvious connection. Remember that the witch language is often in the names of the players. The connection to 2012's Dark Knight shooting event, which was filled with occult symbolism, and the events that led up to the arrest of James Holmes and his subsequent contrived backstory, reeked of MKUltra. And it was the epitome of hermetic theater, and was the start of what would be the long string of mass shootings that were reported in the years that followed. Behavioral programming from this 2012 shooting would be promoted in pop culture by way of movies like 2013's Gangster Squad, and in music videos like Lil Wayne's My Homie Steal through predictive programming, because it was released 6/5/2012, over a month earlier, almost on 6/6. Both Aurora shootings have the markings of Brotherhood staged rituals. The Aurora Dark Knight shooting was done at Century 16 Theater. Century equals 100, 16 added to 100 makes 116, which is an inversion of 9/11. According to astrologers, July 20th was supposed to be a high time for distraction, also the time of coming out of Cancer into Leo, according to these astrotheists, a time that is known as the Witch's Day. So on July 20th, 2012, a mass shooting occurred inside a Century 16 movie theater in Aurora, Colorado, during a midnight screening of the film The Dark Knight Rises. It was the deadliest shooting in Colorado since the Columbine High School massacre in 1999. 666 inverted. Holmes was arrested in his car outside the cinema minutes later. And yes, that's why Bone used East 199.9. And obviously dissociated and catatonic Holmes showed up in court with his hair dyed as the Joker to fit the narrative and as a nod to the hermetic nature of the event. Hermes is the Joker, and Holmes was painted as the shooter. He was also painted or made up to look like the Joker, who was the adversary of the Dark Knight and is the symbol of Hermes, the trickster. In the comics, the Dark Knight, blackout code, dark N-I-G-H-T, is another name for or alter ego of Batman, who is called Bruce Wayne. And there was no reason for this Batman imagery to surface in Wayne's rap video. It had nothing to do with it, unless there is some hidden meaning. And believe it or not, then we have Wayne's World, this iconic fictional spoof of a public access show that's now similar to some of the most viral and sickening blogs, was supposed to take place in Aurora, Illinois. Aurora is 1 hour and 40 minutes or 41 miles from Chicago, which is called the second city or the second New York. New York is called the first city. Chicago also brought us Gangland, which is the crime world's connection to the Brotherhood. Aurora is the Latin word for dawn and is the Roman goddess of the dawn. She traveled from east to west announcing the coming or rising of the sun. Very important concept to Brotherhooders in code. Really, what are the odds that two separate shootings almost 7 years apart would both take place in a city named for the same Queen Mother Goddess, as many Queen Mother Goddess or Moon Goddess figures as there are? From Encyclopedia Britannica, the Greek Eos, the Roman Aurora, in Greco-Roman mythology, the personification of the dawn. According to the Greek poet Hesiod's Theogony, she was the daughter of the Titan Hyperion and the Titaness Thea, and sister of Helios, the sun god, and Selene, the moon goddess. To further decode the Brotherhood language in this event, we must look at the last name of the so-called shooter, Martin. The Brotherhood will use the name Martin, which means Little Mars, to help to instigate wars, hence the relationship between the words Mars and wars, invert the M, and the relationship between Aries and Mars, two different Greco-Romanized names for the same spirit. Whether in the case of operative turned rogue Martin Luther King or fabricated gun violence victim Trayvon Martin, whose promoted image was a composite of faces which included traces of then President Obese's face.
But my main message is to the parents of Trayvon Martin. You know, if I had a son, he'd look like Trayvon. Trayvon Martin could have been me. 35 years ago.
Their false flag game is like chess, not checkers. Here you see Trayvon in the Hollister shirt. Hollister is the name of an ancient Anglo-Saxon origin and comes from the family once having lived at the village of Hollister in the county of Wiltshire. Some note that the name may have been derived from the old English word hollin, which means holly. And most definitely, holly relates to holy, and stir relates to star. It means holy star, incidentally and coincidentally. Their intent is to keep energy in motion and to get you in your feelings so that you don't see the forest for the trees. Could the Brotherhood be going back to an old playbook and using the name Martin once again to help to create tension between the cultures of so-called blacks who aren't black and so-called whites who aren't whites and keep us further away from our true identities and nationalities and our true calling as the brothers and the sisters Christ, those who do the will of the Father, according to his word. Skittle comes from a game. Trey relates to tree as well as three. Could it be that the name Trayvon, Von from the German for from, as in Von Daniken, meaning you're from the Daniken family. Could it be that Trayvon, a name I always thought, as much as I've heard the creative names that black folks come up with throughout my life in public school, I always thought it was a name that sounded like a person who's not of our culture imagining what a black sounding name would sound like. Never met a Trayvon. However, could it be that they're once again using Martin to create war, little Mars, between the quote unquote races? To these devils, war is a game, even psychological race war, to keep you bound by the Brotherhood's never-ending loop of illusion for infinity.
35 years ago.
Whether there was a Trayvon or whether he was sacrificed by his father for the Brotherhood, we don't know. But what we do know is that they changed the names, they changed the numbers so that it fits the Brotherhood narrative and so that they can speak in Masonic witch language freely in front of us, giving messages to one another while we, the uninitiated, are none the wiser. And they do this consistently. Even something as simple as the boy's supposed age, we have to look at twice. 35 years ago, 3 + 5 = 8, the number 8, octo as in octopus, and October, although it is the 10th month, oct means 8. Occult researchers affirm that Saturn ruled the kingdom of Atlantis. The age of Aquarius is the time when occult philosophers expect the new Atlantis to flourish, hence the prefix aqua in the word Aquarius, and Atlantis represents the marine or aqua kingdom. But the key is infinity, 8. Why? Because they believe they will live forever. Like the fallen Adam and Eve who have tasted from the bitter and forbidden fruit of technology. They believe through technology, transhumanism, abandonment of Christ-like values, and through knowledge, the mantra of the Aquarian age, they plan to live forever, such as we saw with Adam and Eve in Genesis 3:22. Through every form of media, they weave this magic that they believe will allow for them to be able to cheat death. They believe they will be able to resurrect, and they will only become dead if they become forgotten. So as long as they live on in memory, or quote unquote in spirit, they believe that they will proverbially live forever. But they're attempting to try to find ways to actually live forever. Here you see the group Queen. Freddie Mercury is Indian, although his band is considered British rock. Freddie Mercury was born Farooq Bulsara from an East Indian family. As further proof that all of them witches, wizards, and magicians, note that Mercury is the Roman name for the Greek spirit Hermes, Gemini, Janus, the double-headed, double-minded, and double-thinking spirit of the enemy. Taking that into consideration, could Queen really be a reference to the devil's disguise as Queen Mother Goddess yet again? They're all connected. Here you see the band is positioned in a pyramid, and Freddy is in the Osiris burial pose known to most of you as the Wakanda X of the Black Panther, as you was told by Zionists who control your art, hide your true identity, and try to sell you a new identity. The pose is significant to Queen partly because the Queen, Isis, or Set, raises the King Osiris or Osir in the Egyptian myth from the dead using a sex magic ritual. Case in point, in the movie Black Panther, it is his mother who resurrects him in honor of this ancient ritual Queen Mother Goddess sex magic tradition. In the Babylonian story, which most mainstream historians say predates the Egyptian story, the slain male deity is resurrected by his wife, which happens to also be his mother. This is the true origin of the profane term, mother. Mesopotamia is the most ancient civilization in the world, as it was located in the Fertile Crescent. There is archaeological and anthropological evidence that proves that Egypt is one of the oldest civilizations in the world, dating the existence of settlements back to 10,000 BC, according to historyplex.com. Through a sex magic and necromancy ritual that causes the disembodied Osiris to resurrect, he becomes his son, Horus, or Heru, the word that gives us hero. That's why this Osiris pose is not unique to your favorite black superhero. If you let media lead you, they will only mislead you. Since when have they created positive role models that are psychologically healthy for our community? Wake up and take the pillow from your head and put the good book in it.
What a silly Negro.
Mockery is a spirit used to incite those who are being mocked into a rage spirit. Here you see a well-known form of black power symbolism. After being briefed on the Aurora shooter situation, the POTUS you know was told to give this gesture, one that is unusual for him and considered to be uncharacteristic for a person of his status, stature, or office to use. So why did he use it? Is he down with the blacks? The Pratt building, like most factories, is large, so another address that was used to describe where the shooting was taking place in Aurora, Illinois, was 641 Archer. The modern term shooter is evolved from the bowman or archer, also symbolized by Sagittarius, which is the mirror reflection of Gemini, a symbol of duality, the number of the wizard. Right there you have 6 + 4 + 1. Duality, or double think, symbolized by 11, is used in mind control and sometimes denotes a story that has both aspects of fantasy and reality intertwined. So in the address 641 Archer, we cannot ignore the archer part. A shooter is nothing but a modern-day archer. A shooter uses bullets, and an archer uses arrows. What does that have to do with any of this? In the supposed picture taken from the scene, you see the FedEx with the arrow. February has given us no shortage on surprises. The Illuminated are making it a very interesting Black History Month. Here's another picture of the supposed shooter, now deceased, Gary Martin, 45, like Trump is 45. Now commonly seen as a hat of choice for Brotherhooders, we see him with a fedora, which is originally meant for and popularized by women. Look at the history. This is another indication of duality, not to mention the gangsta-licious style wife B he's got on in the picture. Final Illuminated reports say that he supposedly wounded four cops. The four officers were members of the Aurora FOP, Fraternal Order of Police, Lodge Number 11, for Hermes, the Joker, the Twins, the Actor. Some truthers debate over whether or not there were any victims in a false flag, which would make it a hoax or staged event. However, ritual sacrifice in the way of their gods requires bloodshed, whether it be done on the actual theater of war or behind a closed Masonic hall door, oftentimes victims' names and other key players in the incident, their names will give it away. Lights, camera, action. Why is the eye that's supposed to be blackened and bruised more wide open than the one that's not? And fresh white bandages with no sign of blood clot. Folks who have followed these mass shootings also notice how the narrative begins to change the longer the reporters, speculate, repeat, and omit information to put you in form and in the military formation they want you to be in. In formation. Sometimes it's at ease, other times it's attack. To keep you guessing and stressing in and out of the infinity loop, their story had changed more times than Messy Jesse Smollett's. The first eyewitness that was giving us details on the Aurora, Illinois shooting was John Probst, reportedly a co-worker of Gary Martin. He said that Martin worked his shift as if all was normal. Then later, reports said that other co-workers were alarmed that Gary even showed up, which then led to the story that he had been let go. Other reports said he had been laid off. The LinkedIn page that matches his profile says that he was a senior project engineer at FedEx. His co-worker Probst gave the impression, although he didn't clearly state this, and the media gave the impression that Martin was just another hourly factory employee. The name Henry Pratt kept being thrown about during this new news that spread north, east, west, and south. So naturally, I wondered, who was he? The Henry Pratt Boiler and Machine Company was incorporated in the state of Illinois on November 1, 1901, with Henry Pratt named as president and treasurer. In 1909, the company moved to 2222 South Halsted Street, and its name changed to the Henry Pratt Company. Henry Pratt, the engineer for whom the company was named, died in December 1914, but because of his excellent reputation, we are told the company retained his name. During World War I, the Henry Pratt Company manufactured propellers for Liberty ships, the Hog Islander ships, and in the 1920s, the company manufactured products for electric power plants and gas plants. The Henry Pratt Company has a tradition of industry firsts when welding came into use in the mid-1920s. Pratt was instrumental in the design and production of the first welded smokestack, which was installed at Commonwealth Edison's Fisk Street Generating Station. Another innovation for the Henry Pratt Company was the design of the first rubber-seated butterfly valve. Pratt applied for the patent in 1930, and it was granted in 1934. These original rubber-seated butterfly valves were created for controlling the flow of air, powdered coal, ash water, etc., under low pressures. At the height of the Depression, Pratt became a prime mechanical contractor for the Century of Progress Exposition, the 1933 World's Fair held in Chicago. Some of the projects that Pratt manufactured for the fair included a cover for the Black Forest ice rink, which rolled out to become a dance floor, a Wonder Baker's display, and an angle iron platform for the U.S. Steel Bessemer converter. Henry Pratt Company then designed a 30-inch water butterfly valve for Duquesne Light and Power in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, after which Pratt targeted other utility companies and the waterworks industry. The American Waterworks Association issued a specification for the butterfly valve in 1954. During the Second World War, the Henry Pratt Company received an order to produce nickel plating machines under the highest material priority rating, a system used to designate projects that were vital to the war effort. The company also provided 16-inch butterfly valves for the Manhattan Project and received a certificate of excellence from the United States Atomic Energy Commission for their work. In the 1940s, in the late 1940s, when sales of butterfly valves began to grow, an additional plant was purchased for the manufacture of valves. The plant, located at 900 Depot Avenue in Dixon, Illinois, was composed of buildings dating back to the Civil War. After the Civil War, the buildings housed the Grand Detour Plow Works, which was a forerunner of the John Deere Company. The plant was closed in 2007. On September 4, 1996, Tyco International Limited of Exeter, New Hampshire, purchased the Henry Pratt Company and then transferred ownership in 1999 to a private investment group headed by Credit Suisse. From 1999 to 2003, Pratt acquired the Ardillo Corporation, assets of Lindsay Fabricators Incorporated, Virginia Valve, CC&E Incorporated, Hydrogate Corporation, Milliken Valve Company, and Jingman Pratt Valve Company Limited. The Henry Pratt Company is a subsidiary of the Mueller Water Products Company. Henry Pratt Company added plunger valves to their product line in 2011 and air valves in 2012. The tradition of heavy investment in research and development continues at the Henry Pratt Company. As a result, Pratt holds numerous patents, and the list of industry firsts for the company is long. But most notable may be their involvement in the evolution of the butterfly valve. The symbol of the butterfly, especially the monarch, for which Project Monarch was named, a division of Project Bluebird. The monarch or butterfly is a symbol used in photo shoots of actors and singers and other entertainers, often, and it is usually to denote those who will be or are already under the Project Monarch programming, which transforms the uninitiated caterpillar into a beautiful butterfly for the brotherhood they believe. And what, if anything, did old Boris Karloff have to do with it? Well, he is known for acting and being the villain in scary movies. Look up his real name. Welcome to the Hermetic Theater with your hermetic hosts from the Brotherhood that be doing the most. Brought to you by the true enemies of the QMGs. Before you depart, let me say this part. In Egyptian mythology, Isis is considered to be Saturn's eldest daughter. Quote, I am Isis, queen of this country. I was instructed by Mercury. No one can destroy the laws which I have established. I am the eldest daughter of Saturn, most ancient of the gods. This country was founded by subjects of the queen mother goddess. Lunatic comes from the criticism of those who worshipped in darkness, communed with the succubus, and howled at the moon as a form of worship. Every queen mother goddess is a moon goddess, and her children are lunatics. Wake up. I'm